Hi, thanks for joining me in this video. Today, I thought of doing watercolor portrait painting in 140 CSM. I know it sounds crazy, but I made it. And I'm gonna give some tips to correct mistakes in watercolor painting at the end. Okay, let's get into the work. These are the brushes that I'm gonna use in size 0, 00, 000, 4 and 6. Here, I'm using Camlin watercolor tubes. And this is the color reference that I did for myself. Okay, for this work, I almost used only these 6 paints. This is the palette that I use, but actually this is a white plate. I feel this is more comfortable to mix paints easily at low cost. This is my 140 GSM watercolor sketchbook that I bought in my local shop. I never used to recommend 140 GSM for watercolor portrait because we have to add lots of layers and waters to blend everything. But in 140 GSM, it will be very difficult and moreover, your paper will start to tear off or buckle or the paint will start to bleed because it can't absorb lots of water. Normally, we use lots of water to blend and layers. But in this, I really used very less water to my paint and I waited for my paper to dry off completely before I do the next layer. And I used tissues to tap off the excess water present in the paper. Because if I add layers with water, it will start to tear, even though I do them after the first layer dried off. So, as you guys can see, I remove the water using the tissue paper in every layers. I generally use this 140 GSM paper for some light painting work. For that, I doesn't have to use lots of water. So this book will be very useful to practice watercolors. But today I'm doing a portrait work. If you guys want to do watercolor portrait, use a paper of 300 GSM. Or at least go with 200 GSM. Because you can learn only in good GSM paper. And this painting, I wanted to look bold and strong with nude makeup. So, I did the bold smoky eyes and for eyebrows, always do the base layer in light shade like brown. And then do the eyebrow details. As a girl, this is like a basic for a makeup that we have to fill the eyebrows with brown or lighter shade than your eyebrow eye color. So, that's what I'm doing here now. And for shadows and face, never use the black paint. Instead, try using the light gray. As I said before in my previous watercolor video, if you use black paint as it is in your work, then it will be very hard to remove or control. So always do the base with lighter colors and then add the black details in it. And for the blush, I use the deep pink and scarlet red to give some pink-orangish look because I did the bold lips using the scarlet red color. This work is totally like a challenge to me to do in 140 GSM paper. Because as you guys can see, it's really very hard to control. My paper starts to tear off and bleeds here and there. Even for the R, I did the same. Instead of adding the black color for the R, I did the base using the yellow and blue and then I added the details. As I wanted the art to be in cooler tone, I did the hair color one by one using the blue and black paint. Brush sizes is up to your choice. Whatever is comfortable for you that you can use. Here, in this I'm using the size 000 brush and 0 brush for better tiny hair strokes. Thank you. and I did the abon and covered them with flowers because this one is very common and trendy hairstyle in South India. The flowers that I did for bun is a really random one. I don't know what flower it is, just use the yellow and green to compromise my cooler tone hair. We in South India, girls love to wear beautiful earrings. So, in this I designed one random blue beads like earring with tiny red stones in it. I said in starting that I will give some tips to correct mistakes in watercolor. For this, one thing that we need is white paint to correct the highlight or to remove the paint that we did my mistakes. Just use the white paint and wait till it dried off. If you felt that highlight is lighter, then add the second layer of white in it so that by adding the white paint layers, your highlights will be saved. Likewise, to remove the paint that you did by mistake, then put the white layer on it. Wait till the white layer dry off and then add the second or third layer white if it's very transparent. Once the layer dried off, that is once the white layer dried off, then do the work above the white layer. So this white paint will be like savior for watercolor mistakes. And this is the tip that I said at starting of the video. Use a white paint to correct your mistakes, highlights, also to remove the excess paint or to do the changes. Instead of using the water to remove the excess paint, you can try this white paint technique. Okay, my work is almost done, finishing with tiny blue puttu or bindi in forehead. And this actually complete my whole work. When your paper exceeds its absorption limit, this white paint came into handy for me. And that's it. Watercolor portrait in 140 GSM paper is done.